Welcome to this special video on UroChannel, where I will cover the different forms of urinary incontinence. This is very useful information on a very important topic that belongs to the core content of urology. Lately, I have received some comments of viewers who want to see more classic urology. And as it happens, next week will be EAU Urology Week. The European Association of Urology has announced urinary incontinence as the topic of the year. All urologists are asked to participate and inform the public about this intimate area of taboo. So I think it is a good idea to have a look at the different forms of urinary incontinence. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. In public, awareness of incontinence only lives in TV commercials. And it seems to be something affecting women only. But this is actually not the case. Incontinence can be seen in both men and women. I would say that men are more prone to urgency incontinence, whereas women get stress incontinence more easily. Okay, so where's the difference? Urgency incontinence most often is caused by an overactive bladder. We call this OAB in urology, and we differentiate between OAB dry and OAB wet. If no urine leaks out, it's OAB dry, and if you can't hold it, it's OAB wet. With advancing age, the detrusor muscle becomes overactive in many people. I am talking about the muscle that enables you to empty your bladder. A sudden compelling desire to void that you can't defer, that's what we call urgency. This kind of urgency is the result of a contracting detrusor muscle. Why it is going wild, nobody knows. These contractions can be very powerful, and the resulting pressure can reach values of 1 meter water column and more. If the pressure is strong enough, you wouldn't be able to hold your water. Urgency incontinence may be the result of an overactive bladder, where we don't find an obvious reason, but urgency incontinence may also be a symptom of an underlying urinary tract infection, stone disease, certain forms of bladder cancer, an enlarged prostate, diabetes, neurologic disease, and others. In other words, urgency incontinence shouldn't be taken lightly because it has to be sorted out. Stress incontinence is not a good term because people immediately think it has something to do with being stressed out. But stress incontinence is the result when the bladder gets under pressure. This is the case when coughing or laughing, and sometimes doing strenuous movements. Because of the pelvic anatomy and childbirth, women are more prone to pelvic organ prolapse and stress incontinence as a consequence of a weak pelvic floor and organ prolapse. Typically, stress incontinence occurs in men after radical prostatectomy for prostate cancer. It is mostly a temporary thing for a couple of weeks or a few months. However, it may persist in some men, and sometimes an artificial urinary sphincter will have to be implanted. Now that you know the difference between urgency and stress incontinence, let's introduce mixed incontinence. Mixed incontinence is both stress and urgency incontinence. Then there's a special form of incontinence by the name of overflow incontinence. Loss of urine is triggered by an overfull bladder here. Usually, residual urine builds up over many years without the individual noticing that the bladder doesn't fully empty itself. Finally, the bladder is so full that the pressure inside the organ exceeds the pressure of the urinary sphincter so that urine will dribble out. Speaking of dribble, post-micturition dribble is not incontinence. The urethra is shaped like a U, and urine may be stored here after you are done voiding because the pelvic floor muscles may not be able to evacuate it. Urine leaks out typically a few minutes later when you sit down, for example. But this is not urine directly from the bladder, but residual urine from the urethra. Therefore, it is not classified as incontinence. Post-micturition dribble is a frequent complaint. By chance, I found an effective way to deal with it. If you want to know what it is, watch this video. See you soon. Bye-bye.